Today I'm going to talk about something out of Australia. It is not Nicole Kidman, it is not Tim Tams, nor is it Uggs. It is tea tree oil, otherwise known as Melaleuca Alternifolia. That's how you're going to see it on the list of ingredients on the back of a cosmetic product that has it. That's its botanical name. And tea tree oil is an essential oil, and it's not essential because you have to have it. It's essential because it contains the essence or the fragrance of the plant that it's extracted from. Tea tree oil ranges in color from transparent to yellow, and it has a very camphorous smell, which people either love or love to hate. I love the smell, but I would be interested in hearing what side of the spectrum that you sit on. I thought I'd talk a little bit about the history and why it's in our cosmetic products. Before it was being used in our modern day cosmetic products, the Aborigines were actually using it first. These native inhabitants of Australia were taking the tea tree leaves and they were crushing them and they were inhaling them to help with respiratory issues. They were putting it into wounds to kill disease-causing microorganisms. And they were drinking it as a tea, probably a pretty terrible tasting tea, but it helped with sore throats. It wasn't until the 1920s though that we started to extract the oil. And that was thanks to some researchers who were looking at essential oils that had commercial potential. One researcher in particular ended up looking at tea tree oil and he noted its antimicrobial activity. That antimicrobial activity is due to one key molecule, and that is terpenin 4-ol. It is in tea tree oil at a high concentration, anywhere between 20 to 48%, which is a lot given that tea tree oil has hundreds of molecules. What's interesting is that it's also found in juniper wood at lower concentrations, and juniper wood is known for being rot resistant, which is why Norwegian farmers use it in their fencing. And when you think about it, that totally makes sense, because if I was a hungry microbe, I would not be chomping into something that was trying to kill me. In cosmetic products, you can find tea tree oil at very low percentages, usually about 1% or less. And that doesn't sound like a whole lot, but it doesn't take a lot of tea tree oil to get antimicrobial activity. From the research that I was looking at, it looks like it could kill most microbes at about 0.5 to 2%, which is pretty impressive when you think about it. Lastly, just because it's called tea tree oil, so tea is in the name, it does not mean that you should drink it. I've been looking online and I've seen reports of people who thought it was a good idea to ingest it, and some of the symptoms have been things like loss of voluntary muscle coordination, drowsiness, that's the easy stuff. There's diarrhea, abdominal pain, and there's also comas. And I looked at the annual report for the American Association of Poison Control Centers, and there was even one death. So don't do it. Just don't do it. They don't have, as far as I can tell, any recommended levels to ingest it at. And the reason for that is because there's so many factors that go into toxicity, like your weight, the concentration of tea tree oil you drink, how frequently you have it, and whether you're allergic to it or not. So this is what came out of this morning's research. I would love to hear what you guys think about tea tree oil, any questions that you might have, any research that you want to share. Definitely let me hear about it in the comment section below. And if you liked today's video, give it a thumbs up. If you want to see more videos like this, subscribe. And if you want to be notified when my videos drop, don't forget to click that bell. We will talk soon. Take care. Bye.